everybody!
Hello, gang!
Welcome back to Ark with Baffled Kaz and Geoff. Woo! With BaffledShadows Gaming. And Geoff has been very busy.
Wee!
Yes. Expanding this crafting area. We've been carrying on work here. Yes. We've taken out all the boxes that were along here. Put new ones on the way up along there. And looks like built around the vaults.
Mm-hmm. So now we have a floor of vaults and easy accessible boxes.
Mm-hmm.
And some help!
Oh no!
Oh no!
Is that the one dangerous bit? There's a gap down there.
There is, a person sized hole. Quick, get a bird!
Let me just get. There we go. Freedom. Rescued!
Yeah, I filled in the back so that wouldn't happen, unfortunately.
And then it happened.
Unfortunately, there was the thing isn't quite equally long, so there's a little bit of a gap.
I wonder if you could put a pillar in there.
That's probably a good idea.
Mm. Anyway, we'll see about that later.
But you probably can't, because it's not going to snap. It's going
to
snap to the middle.
Yeah, it needs to snap, doesn't it?
Yes. It's on the ceiling.
And we've got a nice landing bay up here, so we can say, like, land these guys or the Quetzes. And we're right next to the boxes.
Mm-hmm. Gets them out of the way. Also, did you see what I did with the hatch frames?
Oh, I see.
Because if I just put ceiling, because the vaults will let you overlap fairly significantly, you could put ceilings down here, but then you couldn't open the vaults.
Oh yeah, it just goes pin code, doesn't it?
Yeah. However, with the hatch frames in, you've got a line of sight to the centre of the thing, so it lets you access the inventory.
Good thinking, Batman.
Woo!
So, need to move that electric cable at some point.
Yes.
These are apparently death traps. It's like if you jump off something onto a cable, the hit detection goes crazy and then the game kills you because it thinks you're somewhere inescapable or something like that. I've died a few times to that. It's actually quite embarrassing.
Well,
yes. So we've got a nice walkway around the back here.
Yeah, we've got a loading dock here. You should be able to fit the mammoth in it. Aha. I did test it.
Cool. So mammoth-sized things can get in there? Or
yeah.
Do you think a Rex can get in there?
Yeah, Rex can get in easy.
Awesome.
So you've got loading docks. We've got the vaults and the grills down at the bottom.
Yep. I put in a second grill because I find that even with one grill, it's if you had a lot of meat to cook up, you're kind of sitting there babysitting it for ages, gradually shoving in more meat and taking out that's cooked, so two of them will help speed that up. And put in a couple of preserving bins over here. I actually think that if we want to make more, you could probably double them up. There's enough space on this side to do another two.
Yeah.
But for now, two will do. we tend to make more jerky than we use, so it's a bit overboard to do more than that.
Oh, we've got a nice little journey room now.
Yes. With a glass door. So since we basically stored the gasoline in here, we've got a little door to get into the side, and then we can grab that. I should grab a bit now, actually. Because
we have things
next on the agenda is making that industrial grinder. But I spent some time off camera gathering up a whole bunch of stuff. Like 600 polymer, 600 oil, 800 cementing paste, 2,000 crystal. That was the biggest headache. And then thousands upon thousands of metal.
Well, at least we had that crystal outpost.
Yep, there was actually still a lot of crystal back at the old mining outpost that I could gather from. Right, so turn this on and go to crafting and industrial grinder. Goodbye, all you materials. Practically filling up the thing to do it. Off again. One industrial grinder. Let's see how big this is. This is about maybe 50 to 2/3 longer than the fabricator. Probably can I fit it in here? Oh, it looks like it's slightly too long to fit in that gap.
Curses!
I'm gonna have to fit it that way, I'll block off that ramp.
You can move the ramp.
Yeah, we can put it in the middle here where the boxes used to be.
No, I don't want it in the middle.
No. I suppose we can do that. Can we get this in here? Aha, yes, it will fit in here, so if we just move that around, like you said.
Hang on. I'll knock this out, and we should have a wooden railing to put in.
Let me just get this as neat as I can.
2 seconds.
Okay.
There we go.
Fence achieved! Right. So, there. This is straight. Woo! Big hefty machine.
Good chunk. Yes. It's definitely big.
Yes, you can still fit through here, yeah.
Yeah.
There we go. Right. So, as I mentioned last time, this thing can grind up. That looks like you can just grind up wood into thatch and flint, well, stone into flint. Well, that'll be handy if we want lots of spark powder. Use the excessive amounts of stone we end up with to make that. But it looks like those are the only two resources that will grind down into other resources. Its other function being, you know, you can put in crafted items, like we've got some pikes here. And you can grind them down into some of its material.
Cool.
The information I looked at said it was a quarter of the material that went in. And it can do stuff like items, like weapons, saddles, and structures.
Mm-hmm.
Although I think with structures, if you build a structure piece and then demolish it, you get half of the resources back.
Yeah.
So if you've got one or two pieces, it's probably quicker and you'll get more out of it if you just place them and demolish them. But if you've got, you know, stacks upon stacks of things you want to get material back from, it might be quicker but less efficient to do it with a grinder. Anyway. So apparently there's no on button in the interface, so you have to come back out and turn it on with the context thing. You click on that and you've got grind selected item. There we go.
Grind away!
So we've got 3 wood, 3 metal, and 5 hide out of the pike. So I've got a damage pike here and I'm curious to see if it gives me the same amount. But yeah, looks like you get the damage one didn't give less.
Yeah. Cool.
That's quite handy if you've got a bunch of stuff you don't need, or if you're getting a whole bunch of useless low-tier stuff from drops, that'll probably be quite good. Yeah, it looks like, I think it was 5 thatch to a wood. So that might be another way of supplementing thatch. Just get masses of wood with the beaver and then just go thatch, craft all. Oh, that's quick. Nice.
Have we replaced moose then? Is moose superfluous?
Maybe.
Put moose.
Oh, it depends on if we've got lots of spare wood. If we don't have lots of spare wood, then you know maybe moose would be better.
Yeah, but it's fairly easy to get wood.
Yeah, you just that's true.
Tromp out with splinters and hit everything, whereas thatch takes a bit longer to get similar quantity.
Well, I suppose then moose can retire. Oh, moves.
Then again, it doesn't cost petrol to get thatch from moose.
Just didn't yesterday when you were gathering stuff, didn't you gather stuff with moose and didn't you have like, was it 40,000 here on him before you actually got weighed down? You
basically ditched
everything else.
Yeah, it can carry boxes and boxes and boxes of thatch, but it takes quite a while to gather that.
Yeah. Well, I suppose this will be a handy alternative if we don't want to go out on moose.
You need to hit a lot of trees, that's what I'm saying. Mm. Anyway, I've got the new ramp in.
Ooh, ready to go.
It's further along. It's over here.
Aha. Ooh. Nice. Ooh. Nice big crafting area now.
It just occurs to me, you know, we could have used one of the staircases, but I don't think it'll fit.
No, I think that's a bit low.
Well, I think because it snaps from the bottom, doesn't it?
Oh yeah, and it snaps.
So we'd mount the...
You need something down here.
Yeah.
The ramps work fine.
Yeah. Oh well.
So, good work, I say. Awesome looking place.
Grinding.
Well, you know all of those useless saddles we get, like Ascendant parasaur or stuff like that. We shove them in here and get all of the hide and stuff out of them.
Well, maybe not the ascendant parasaurs, but... Yeah.
Oh, wait, I think there's a limit on stuff. You can't just get gobs and gobs of stuff off something ascendant. It's, if the wiki is accurate, then... The resources you get out of each item, like each type of resource you get from it, is capped at 100. So if you put in, you know, a nifty ascended bit of material that took, you know, thousands of hide, it would just cap that at 100. It would only give you 100.
Yeah. But it might be something to do with the rarer saddles we get. Like the higher quality ones, because they usually require, like, metal or cementing paste or polymer or something.
Yeah. Still, looks like we'll be in handy addition, if only for the thatch and the flint.
It makes our crafting corner look a bit more professional.
Yeah. All the machines on this side.
It's nicely decorative, at least.
Looks like it doesn't need power either from the junction box, it just needs the petrol.
That's good.
Yep. Right. So, next on the agenda, we have the Pelagornis, didn't we?
We're going stork hunting.
Yes. and luckily it seems to be it's if you fly along the coast, you'll run into some eventually. I'm pretty sure there's some pretty much directly south of us, next to the South Island.
Well, let's find out, shall we?
Yep, we shall indeed. There's a small selection of them. One there.
You didn't even have to go far.
A couple over there. Yeah. Like I said, they tend to be around coasts. I'm pretty sure I saw them on the... the frozen coast up north when I went to get some oil.
Mm-hmm.
Flapping about over there.
Now, let's remember to change into my trap darts. Bullets.
Don't want to use the bullets. Right. Ooh. Apparently, bowlers are apparently a handy thing to get them to stay still over land. So we'll have them handy. Because... if you shoot them over water and they're not basically sitting like that one over there is... oh, it's taken off now. But if they're sitting on the water and they're downed, it's they just stay on top of the water. But since it's probably going to take more than one dart to down one with these guns, probably best to get one over...
Come on down!
Already?
Sorry.
That was quick. Ooh, it was level 44 as well. I think that was the highest of the levels around here. Right, so here's some cooked prime fish.
Ooh, I've not seen the cooked prime fish.
Aha.
That looks quite cool.
Yeah, pretty good. It looks like, well, when I was holding it, it had...
some lemon.
lemon on fish. So yeah, it looks like,
the cooked prime citronol?
had about an hour on its timer when it was cooked.
Yeah.
And it, I think it had about 4 days when it was in the fridge.
Cool.
So it's quite handy. Oh, look at those.
Another one down. This one's only level 28.
I feel superfluous. Right, I'll bring over some of this fish. Right. If you want to get some regular fish as well, there should be some on Tornado. Where are you?
I'm over here across the beach.
Most of this is a beach.
Well, across...
north?
South, towards the island, yeah. Hello!
Huh?
Just keep going.
Ah, there you are.
It's behind me.
Okay. I think I see that flat dark line on the ground over there.
They're fairly easy to knock out. Although I did nearly kill one.
Yeah, it's, I think they're low health, and yeah, it doesn't take that many darts. I've only got one saddle. Oh well. yeah. Look at the teeth on them. It's, you can see them all on the one over there. It's where it looks like it's the very, very spiky beak.
Yeah.
Kind of dangerous.
Well, from, don't forget to keep an eye on the top or...
I won't.
They don't really have a lot, so it goes down fairly quickly.
Yeah. So you didn't get too much tearing stuff out of this fish. But then again, cooked isn't ideal. It's only about half as effective as
before,
right?
I'm not sure the specific amount, but yeah, it's not as good as raw.
Yeah. Alright, hopefully that'll be fine while I go and get some fish.
Fish.
Like I said, there was a bit on tornado. Don't take all of it, I need some. Ah! Just tripping over a trilobite there.
Whoops.
You took all of it.
What?
Any more on hurricane? No.
Oh, do you want the fish for?
You put on the other one.
Ah, I was gonna do that.
Right, okay then, if you're sorting out both of them.
Cool. Today's fish
leaving
is trapped a la creme.
Fish! Today's fish is trapped a la creme. I was worried about making sure there's always somebody next to each of them. I was worried about making sure there's always at least someone next to each of them.
Why?
In case something comes and eats one of them while we're not paying attention.
Oh. Well, running backwards and forwards between them isn't too hard.
True. You don't have any normal bullets. I do.
I do.
Just in case of trouble. As trouble comes a knocking. You there?
Yeah.
Are we switching places? But yes, apparently very easy to down. Possibly hard to actually came up, depending on where you down it. Because if it... Like I said, if it's, as I was saying before, if you down it in the water, it will fall into the water and start drowning. Unless it was sitting on the water when it was down. And so basically, if you're doing that, you need to get it in one hit. Which, you know, the Uber rifle might be able to do. What are you doing?
Yeah, if it's low level and it can get a good headshot off, then you should imagine even the regular rifles should be able to do it.
Yeah. Hopefully if it's, for lower levels, it doesn't just kill it in one shot. Are you just collecting as many as you can see now?
Maybe. Have you got your bowlers?
Yes. I can give them to you if you want.
Do you want to come over here? Hello, bird.
Where should I?
Should I
equip them?
Ooh, 68.
68? I think we're going to need to get more just fish.
Yeah.
Yeah. If you want to get bitey. Right, let's see if I can actually... Which one? This one?
This one.
Gotcha. Whoa.
Headshot!
Okay. Yeah, I don't think
these apparently have hit locations.
Okay. Hitting the
as
head
opposed to
matter.
The Allosauruses.
Right.
Do you want to go get some fish, and I'll take care of these, and then
we'll come
see
back.
If we can get them all tamed up?
Yes. I'll just check on this one. Give you a bit more narcotics. I'll dump some bit more on you. Okay, we will be back. Once we've got these wrangled. Okay, doing well. Got these two up?
Got two of them up.
Who are apparently Fisher and Fisher Price. And yes, meantime, collecting lots of raw fish and raw prime fish meat.
Yeah, so let's see how much this one will feed up.
Aha. See if we can spam this all at once. Going up.
Chunk, chunk, chunk.
Om nom nom
oh,
nom.
Oh wow, even
nom,
the
nom,
raw
nom,
prime
nom,
fish
nom,
is
nom.
Kind of terrible.
Yeah. I suppose the options are limited. It's outside of the kibble. You have to use, you know, raw prime fish, cooked prime fish, or just raw fish.
Yeah.
And if they're all terrible for the taming effectiveness, well, you can't really help that.
That's true.
I was hoping to have at least some compy kibble by now, but... I gathered up some more compies I found. So we have three females.
Mm-hmm.
And it just seems they are just not laying eggs. I'm not sure if it's some kind of quirk with our server settings or something like that, but...
They're just being reticent.
Maybe. But, you know, from what I can tell, it's, you know, they should be laying eggs. Yay! They should be laying eggs, but for some reason, for us, they're not. So we just had to use the kingfish.
Well, yeah, but I mean, you know, lots of things have trouble laying eggs.
Yes. Anyway.
There we go.
Believe it or not, I was actually surprised when I first found this out, based on how big they look. You can actually fly on these. So I'm just going to fly on Kingfisher. Hold still. There we go.
Oops.
Huh? Problem?
Nope.
Nope.
I was changing their aggression and accidentally hit the wrong button.
Got my scuba mask on. I'm going to take this off. Yes, I was out on Berlusconi using a pick on sharks. Since that gets you prime, well, prime fish. Hey, cool. It looks like they don't have a massive amount of carry weight, so...
No.
Even though they can carry a rider, they probably can't carry much with it.
How much weight does Kingfisher have?
That's 122.
Ouch.
Yeah. So you probably 122, need to...
122, that's quite low.
Yeah, so you probably need to focus some levels on that.
Fisher has 134.
Yeah. So this is sprinting, which is quite slow.
Hmm.
Yes.
Do you want to hop off?
Yep.
Lurp. Level 91. And all of it's gone into terrible stats. Well, I suppose the health.
Health and then terrible stats.
Yeah.
Well, that's that assignment for you. They like putting stuff in food.
Wow.
Yes. Well, these things are apparently good at getting, fish, unsurprisingly. But also organic polymers, so...
Doesn't look like it's got a grab.
No. Well, somehow I imagined it couldn't. So I do wonder, it's, since they can sit on the water, duck style, can they do that with a rider on it? You want to try in the shallows? See if you can land on the water.
Doom!
Awesome!
Oh, that's handy. Whee!
Yay! The smallest of rafts.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. I was worried that you couldn't, because you'd be too heavy, but... Yeah.
Well, my concern was how it would interact with water and flying, knocking people off, but...
It's going to be a very cute, tiny boat.
Swan boat. Love boat. Alright, not bad.
Yep.
Back to base?
Yep. If we gather all these together. You want to get these birds following you, and I'll take Berlusconi back home.
Sounds like a good plan.
Away! Take a hurricane. I'm wondering how aware you get them to get fish unless it's in the shallows.
Flying birds.
Because if they're good at getting fish, but presumably they can't dive underwater.
Keeping up okay.
Maybe because you can't speed off ahead because you're too heavy.
Well, I'm on a 120% movement speed RG and they're keeping up okay with that.
Oh, you're on the RG, I thought you were. On the Fisher King. Kingfisher. Whichever. Ooh, there's more Pelagornis flying about over here. Yeah. So, yeah, apparently good at getting fish as well as polar, but I'm not quite sure how you get them other than the shallows. Just to try and peck a shark to death at the surface.
Well, obviously, they don't be very good at sharks, but.
Yeah.
Yeah, flying with the rivers and whatnot.
Yeah.
There'll be a load of mega piranha and.
I wonder if they get it off penguins while you're getting polymer.
Well, I wouldn't think they would.
It was
drop meat, not fish meat. Oh, the lag as the base loads.
Oh, yeah. All the things it has to gradually load in.
Blah.
Yeah, my scuba gear badly needs repairing.
Well, you have been underwater a fair bit.
Yeah. Because I didn't repair it much from the last time when we were spending long stretches underwater.
Yeah.
And when I first thought about it, it was a case of I was busy trying to get everything I needed onto the fabricator for doing the industrial grinder.
Land.
So, yeah.
Land birds. Well, I suppose you're sea birds, but land!
Oh, you.
Come on, Fisher Price. I know you're a bit feeble, but... Doesn't want to land. It's just going to hover there indefinitely.
Oh. It'll figure out it eventually.
Mm-hmm. Oh no!
What did you do?
I dismounted over the side.
Yes.
Fortunately, it didn't kill me.
Oh, good.
It just hurt a lot. Ouch.
Okay, let's see if we can grab fish from the shallows.
It's a bunch over at the back here.
see any. Oh, well, at least it immediately lands, so less danger of getting knocked
Zoom.
Off. Let's see anywhere I am.
Over here? Some. Right beneath me.
Ah. You can bite from the surface while you landed.
Yes, you can. I'm not sure what the range is, but yeah.
It's like reverse jaws. Instead of something coming from the water to get me, it's me getting stuff from the water.
Flippers? Paddle pods? I don't
know. Ha! That's cool. Got ya!
What are they dropping? What?
Meat? I think it's fish. Yeah, just raw fish.
Just raw fish.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
It's something that does the prime.
Yeah, I don't think any of these smaller fish can drop prime.
Jump salmon. Doesn't the salmon drop prime?
Maybe. Just got standard fish from that one. Maybe the bigger ones? I don't know. I don't want the fish today. They all disappeared because I was using the fishing rod earlier. Like it's, oh no, they're back!
Must be.
I'll try the next shallows over next to the pen. Because there's a bit behind it that sometimes has a bunch of fish in it.
Okay.
Sploosh! If only orgies could do that. Ah, stupid glare from the sun.
Get stabbed!
Ow! Won't make a part on it. Arr!
Yeah, the salmon drop raw prime.
Oh, yes, we're not getting any.
Well, yeah, it might not pick any up.
Yeah, maybe it can't.
Because most animals can't get raw prime fish.
Yeah, salmon. Yeah, that was just a lot of raw fish.
Yeah, if you're just getting a lot of the regular fish meat, then it won't be able to get the prime.
Nah, it can't. Still, if you wanted a lot of fish, that's a way to get it.
But we have bitey now.
That's true.
Although
you'd need Lazarus chowder or repaired gear to spend time doing that.
Not necessarily. You could run up, like,
it's on the surface.
Near the coast.
Okay. Whee! You were doing more stuff at the back with the area that's going back, weren't you?
I was, yes. The fence posts?
Mm-hmm.
Well, fence foundations don't look like they're blocking spawning.
Yep.
So if you want to get the Bronto around,
indeed, we'll get a little job.
We'll knock everything out, and I'm going to put some railings up or something.
Yep, because I had already tried out after you put the fence foundations in, knocking over the stuff that was there.
Cool.
And it looks like you know all of that has grown back, so we'll have a little area.
Well, that's what we want. Right, where's the
beep, beep, beep. Pronto reversing. To avoid all these turtles getting in the way.
Well, as soon as we can get the spawns reblocked, they can be moved. They're just our
they're the first line of defence, yeah. They'll just bite everything to death. So glad we haven't had anything too dangerous spawning in the meantime, while we've been doing all this.
No, it looks like we've still got the majority of them blocked. Turn around.
Come on, this way.
Can you see where I'm putting the fence down?
Yep.
You need to have your legs this
side. The
side
of that. Okay.
I want to see how much you can hit.
Let me just turn around. Not sure how much we'll be able to reach from outside.
Well, hopefully the gigantic tail will do most of that for us.
There we go. I am still outside, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, lag!
Can you hit all the trees?
I think so. It's just a matter of...
Get it going.
Yeah. Get one of them.
No, you can just hit those two. Wait. Turn again. Yay!
Hey, I'm actually getting that one at the back there.
Yeah, you are. Yeah, can I get the other one?
I think that's as far as I can get.
You can get these.
If I go
cool.
Around, if I go around this bit here, I might be able to reach the other bits. But it looks like the majority of it, I can.
Cool. Well, knock everything out.
Ooh, I can get that one from here. Cool. Just need to shuffle Little John up and down this bit.
Cool. Well, knock everything out. I've got some railings there, and I've got some door frames there. Just in case the walls, like, because they're actual wall sections, whereas they're just railings.
Ah, right.
So I'm curious to see if they have any different effects on
each one. Oh, right, so if they extend the blocked area and such.
Yeah.
So, a few berries from that. Just to use this to feed everything from within the base. Don't have to go gathering as much.
Yeah, it'd be nice. So I need to wait for that to regrow and see how it goes.
I'm going to put Little John back for now.
Okay.
We'll back it within mate boosting range.
We have three bushes.
Okay, it looks like having stuff on those fence foundations is pushing it back quite a lot.
Yeah. Well, that's why I had it extended out quite a fair ways, but apparently not far enough.
Right. So it looks like we'll either have to have no fence and leave the place open to danger, or have the fence much further out.
Yes, which will defeat the point of having the fence, because the point of having the fence was we can hit it with a Bronto while still being protected.
Can Brontos hit things over a 3-high wall? Would have thought they would be able to.
Yeah.
Mm.
Why?
Oh yeah, but it would be too far back for a hit.
Yeah, that's my point. The, you know, like the bushes that are left are pretty much where that last tree was that you couldn't hit.
Ah.
So.
Well, just having to go outside to gather things as usual then. This is not feasible.
Maybe. I might play around with some different forms of blocking it off.
Well.
That's a shame. I would have liked to have a little garden, but oh well.
Okay, well that was successful.
Yep.
Awesome crafting area done. 3 Pelagornis, because Geoff tranks everything in sight.
Why not? I had a gun. They were landing all over the place.
True. And. Sort of successful experiment with the fence things. We at least know how it's reacting.
We have results.
Yes. So, successful day.
Indeed. Although the Pelagornis are apparently terrible.
Yeah.
You can't tame them for anything. Their weight is terrible.
Mm.
Oh well.
It's hard to get anything with prime fish with them because that's sharks, basically. Oh wait, they don't pick it up at all, do they?
No, nope, they don't get any prime fish.
So, they're good for pecking penguins to death to get organic polymer, but I think that's about it.
They're good if you want mobile boats.
Yeah.
That's about it.
Oh, well. They do make cute noises, though.
Well, that's the most important thing.
Yeah. It's one of the most important things.
And they lay eggs, so...
Yeah. That might be important for something later on. Still, thanks for joining us, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Bye, gang.